Well, hello and a good win to the Bears. But now, welcome to Seven's coverage of rugby's Tri-Nation series. Today, highlights of the New Zealand-South Africa clash in Christchurch. Conditions chilly at Lancaster Park, but things certainly hot up when the haka begins anyhow. There'll be plenty of passion in this clash, the Kiwis hell-bent on avenging their loss to the Springboks in last year's World Cup final. Well, no surprises in the All Black lineup, but there is in the South African side with Johan Roo replacing Van der Vesse.
Megson, there it goes. 75 years of tradition between the All Blacks and the Springbok continues. And the first, from the first moment, physical confrontation between players.
It's the mark.
Mulder and Little. Sean Fitzpatrick, the New Zealand captain, number two. And we go back for the first scrum. With me today, former All Black Grant Fox.
Well, already we see the tension in the air. Both sides very fired up this afternoon.
Bring it up. Bring it up. Bring it back. Come here. Don't want to see any use of that. I saw that. Penalty against you.
That's a penalty for a headbutt by John Allen. Very clear. Referee Ray Mitchell, there it is from John Allen. Fitzpatrick turned and looked towards the touch judge.
So Andrew Mertens just needs to start this at the goalpost and there shouldn't be any deviation.
It's on its way from the local hero, and what a start for the local hero. 3-0. Mark Andrews at the front, Marius Hertup with the headband. Tyshman is number 8. Mertens letting it go. Straight to Lomu, midfield. The slippery part at halfway. A lot of attention on Lomu. Marshall and Mertens, they've got this uncanny ability to find each other. Not such a good kick that time. Presented it to Small. And Walter Little might be in trouble here for that charge.
See the replay. That's a bit rough. Referee Megson on Walter Little. Walter jumped for the charge down. There's no way he can move in the air. James Small really had no option but to try and go through him, and drew a fortunate penalty.
Inside the 22. For New Zealand. Ah, touch judges on the field. This is Ken McCartney, Scottish World Cup referee. Well, if they turn this penalty around, it'll be 3 points, a gift penalty for South Africa.
The ball, right? That's indication to me. I've got to play that, all right?
The penalty has been ripped, and this was one that South Africa could just about throw over. Look at the crowd in the background, very still and concentrating hard. And very well hit by Stransky. The indiscretion by Zinzanbrook cost the All Blacks 3 points.
And so we came back for the penalty.
Lomu now at halfway, no room for the big man to move. From the side. Well struck by Mertens, but it curls across the front. Touchdown. No change. 3-3. No tries yet in the game coming to the end of the first quarter. Stransky lets it go to Fenter. Stransky on the loop. Mulder through. Caught by Jones. With the headgear today, Michael Jones. Fast hands, South Africa change of direction from Stransky to Fenter, to Andrews, an overlap, gives it to Joubert, and there's the try, Andre Joubert. He didn't score a try in all of the tests for the Springboks in their epic year 1995, but he's scoring them again in 96.
That's a well-executed try by the Springboks. The ball won by Andrews at the line-out, swung to the left. The ruck formed, the play switched back to the right. Andrews waiting there, running well. Joubert hitting the line superbly. I thought he had lost control there. Did very, very well, Andre Joubert.
Outside, it must have gone right over the top of the post, and that's it. 8-3. Andre Joubert's try is unconverted. 8-3 to South Africa. Allen throws, not so good there from Andrews. Rue is in trouble. Quarter flag is just to the left, and Mark Andrews, an uncharacteristic slap at the ball. That was awful for him, Wayne Graham.
Yes, it was. It was not like Andrews at all. He just whacked it back to Johan Rue, and the All Blacks were very, very quick to bundle him up and put him across the touchline. Zinzan Brook, of course, in there to get the ball out, but the option wasn't there. Now the Springboks have the heat on them.
Fitzpatrick throws. It must be a penalty.
That's what I told you. You're turning round. No.
No. Let's have a look at that. Free kick to South Africa. They're trying to run it out. Ruben Kruger. This tough man, the quiet achiever of South African play in recent years. Stransky with Robin Brook on him. Mertens trying to find the runners. Here comes Cullen, is onto him. Buried in the turf, Christian Cullen. It's there for New Zealand. Marshall, Mertens. Stransky, this is a long piece of play here. Mask, Kwanfeld. A penalty for New Zealand in the muddy cricket pitch area. And Fitzpatrick has it. What's he going to do? There's the distance. They'll have the shot. Rather unsure footing. And that has just meant he's bent it outside. Tough one, that one, Grant, with the ground so soft there.
That's a penalty. He's in the air. You're just taking him out.
Well, that's one of the worries of the new line-out law. If a man is hoisted high and you go under him, it's very dangerous. And the New Zealanders were penalised for going underneath Andrews and not allowing him to come down.
Well, that's part of the problem with allowing lifting in the line-out.
Gently struck, but it's away.
He didn't allow the Springboks to release it or take it to ground.
Remember, New Zealand and South Africa will play each other 5 times in the next 6 weeks. Walter Little through. Bunce knocked down. It'll be a penalty. That's a deliberate knock on by Andre Joubert.
No chance of catching. No, thank you.
And I think Fitzpatrick is suggesting there might have been a penalty try there, because it was a deliberate knockdown and the pass was on its way between Little and Bunce.
Referee Ray Megson saying to Sean Fitzpatrick, watch it on the replay. The cut there, Mertens, Little on the inside, the fend through the midfield. Frank Bunce had a clear run to the line here. Joubert knocking it down deliberately.
And through it goes from Mertens. It's a 2-point lead for South Africa. Yes, indeed, what a legend he's writing for himself, this young star of the All Blacks. 8-6, though, South Africa still leads. There's a bit of claret around. They're giving blood for the colours today, these two teams. Fitzpatrick and Robin Brook. Marshall, who's tough as teak as a halfback. Craig down, getting back. Number two seemed to go over the top. The referee might have seen that one as well. Kronfeld. Robin Brook battling up towards halfway. The New Zealand backs lined out in attacking zone.
Hey, 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 hey. Hey, hey, hey.
And Susan Brook and John Allen, an altercation.
Keep it quiet.
This is Ken McCartney again.
Come on, come on, come on.
Referee saying two boys just playing silly. Well, I won't repeat what he said. Clear niggle game. A lot of feeling. Very tight and close contest.
Right on half, this will be the last play before the break. Coming to Marshall. Out to Mertens. Out to Little. Out halfway. The big one for Wilson. Hendricks has got him covered. Good run by Wilson. That'll be half time. What an epic struggle it is. 8-6. South Africa have the only try so far, and they lead by two at the break. You won't want to miss the second half. We'll be back with it shortly.
Coming soon to Seven, a major television event.
Back at Lancaster Park, the second half begins. The All Blacks against the Springboks. They've been doing it to each other for 75 years, and this one is right in line with the hard tradition of tough football between these two great rugby nations. The score stands 8-6 to South Africa at half time.
Strunsky again from the kickoff, picking out Zinza and Brook, but rather than kick for touch from the narrow angle, he took the forwards on to give Andrew Mertens more opportunity to gain ground, which he's done.
80% of the games between these two countries have been decided by 8 points or less. So they're used to playing tight ones. Wilson going high. He just got that nice run towards the end of the first half. Lost forward by the Wilson fingertips. Frank Bunce heading back, his 38th test today. I said before, the oldest back ever to play for the All Blacks, heading towards the world record now, held by Hugo Porter, who was 39 when he played his last test. The oldest for a back. And there's Oz-Peter Durant, stopped by Michael Jones, the hard-tackling New Zealand flanker.
Put it down in the tackle, flatten the ball back, stand your feet.
The All Black loose forwards working in combination of defence. Zinzan Brook making the first tackle. Cronfeld assisting and Jones picking up the runner. Here we have Zinzan, the Michael Jones, who's picking up the runner coming forward. He's very good at that as Michael Jones making the offensive tackle. A Springbok hand going in there and lifting the ball out of the ruck. And that's what the penalty was for.
Today's referee is Ray Megson from Scotland, who controlled the Bledisloe Cup match in Auckland last year. Up goes Robin Brook. The big hands of number three, Olo Brown, wrap around the ball. And away goes the All Black pack. And Robin Brook skips into the open. And at the 22, it's Cronfeld, wrapped up by Hendricks, number 11, and South Africa have it. It's come to Rue. Fast hands to Fenter, to Ruben Kruja. And Marshall and Mertens drag him down, number seven, Johan Roo. Joost van der Vesthuizen is apparently on the bench and available to play should he be required. A good kick by Roo, who was the late replacement. And back goes Pycock Cullen and touches it down. Touch judge on the field again.
All Blacks did the tackle the boy, just shoulder muffed the ball way down there. Miles away, it's a penalty to the Springboks. Way down there.
All the way down.
Yeah.
Number four.
Well, Ken McCartney's been in the game.
It's against
four
you.
Or five times.
Take the man out, non tackle, off the ball, okay? Yeah. We go all the way back to the penalty.
Well, I thought I heard the touch judge say number four, and they spoke to Robin Brook. He's number five, so maybe they got the wrong guy.
Yes, I don't know if that's too much of an advantage for the Springboks either. I would have thought it would have been better to let it go.
It was Mr. Brook.
Well, isn't that nice? Called him Mr. Brook.
Well, I would think the touch judge's role is for foul play. And I don't believe that if it was Robin Brook, it was foul play. He just went in to clean out players near the ruck. And he was picked up by this man, Ken McCartney. And again, I think he's trying to be the star of the show.
12 penalty kicks and free kicks to 8. New Zealand have been awarded more. What's going on here?
Free kick.
So Fitzpatrick trying to get a bit of urgency into the game. Oh, what a tremendous clash of heads. I could hear the bones crack from up here. They're tough, these guys. And this is as hard as it gets. Frank Bunce, the All Blacks are trying to come up a gear. Jeff Wilson, 22 ahead. Marshall, Mertens, wide to Lomu. Joubert and... Jonah's got it. Cullen. They've changed speed of a run. But it almost went wrong. And is way, way back on the 22.
That was for Brendan Fenter, offside in the midfield. And both the midfield backs of the Springboks, Yaphi Mulder and Brendan Fenter, have been close to the offside line all day. It's the first time referee Mexen has picked them up. Here we see here.
Referee was pointing there, Grant, wasn't he?
Well, it was Stransky or Fenter. I thought it was Fenter from our vantage point.
It might have even been Kruger, Grant, in the midfield, but whoever it was, they've been trying to shut the All Blacks down, not allowing them to get it wide to Lomu and Wilson, trying to cut them off midfield.
This to put New Zealand into the lead. It's handy enough. He knows the ground well. Andrew Merton sends it through. New Zealand have the lead. 5 minutes into the second half. Slightly muddy Lancaster Park. Rugby New Zealand's big game on two sports action from Lancaster Park in Christchurch. Brook back to Mertens, who's scored all of New Zealand's points so far. And Johan Roo brings it forward. Punching it to the corner flag, and he bounces it across. Here's a good attacking position as the Springboks swing back into the hot zone.
Well, at this level, missing touch can be critical. Johan Roo's got a very educated boot, and this is pinpoint accuracy, probably 6 inches inside the touchline.
The goal on his top left. New Zealand are defending. Up goes Ian Jones. The crowd roar his name. Jonesy from the bank. Marshall clears it. Penalty for New Zealand. Mr. Mexen whistling a merry tune today.
And Ian Jones, supreme in the lineup this afternoon. The lifting role has really helped him. Fitzpatrick on the button once again. Jones being assisted into the air. Two-handed take. The drive going on for the All Blacks, drawing the penalty.
And sunlight coming out across Lancaster Park. It's a nice afternoon, about 10 degrees Celsius today. And not much sunshine in the international season in New Zealand earlier in matches we've seen, but it's a nice day in Christchurch at the moment. And rugby players here concentrating as never before. Jones again. There's the power pack. They had sped the game up a few moments ago. Let's see what they're doing now. Bunce. They're offside again. All offside, says referee Mexen. Stransky and company further out. Now, Grant Fox, you mentioned this to me at halftime, that this was happening, and it looks like referee Mexen has decided to pick it up and blow it in the second half.
Well, perhaps the touch judges have said something to him at halftime. Quick throw in.
New Zealand has stopped that one going 5 metres. High from Roo. Cullen coming forward again with Hendricks. A great catch by Cullen. Claimed again. It was off his boot by Ian Jones. Jeff Wilson's doing good work in the forwards there. It's come on the South African side. Another penalty for New Zealand.
Hands back.
What a catch this was.
Superb. Eyes on the ball, committed to coming forward, and still prepared to have a go with a wall of Springboks in front of him.
There it is. 17 penalties and free kicks to 9. That's a lot for what we've seen earlier this season. There's a lot of penalties being blown today.
Yeah, 14-5 penalty count. It's a lot of penalties compared to other matches we've seen this season.
Ian Jones, superb again. Olo Brown rolled it round. Marshall frees it. Merton spins it. Little pulls it from behind his hip. Fed beautifully by Bunce. Out it goes to Lomu land. Jonah gets crunched, another penalty for New Zealand. It was around the neck, penalty, says referee Mixon, the Scot.
What? Right? Just hold it.
James Small looking very agitated out on the wing. And they've taken a tap. Mertens. Oh, there's another penalty coming. The South Africans have lost their rang at the moment. That was Brendan Fenter pulling the shirt of a New Zealand player before the man had received the pass. His head drops. Let's have a look at the high tackle on Lomu. There it is from Small, riding around his neck. The referee has called out as high. Here's the second one. You see Fenter to the left pulling Walter Little away from the ball. Pina has called the team together and he's talking, I'm sure, about their discipline on and off the ball.
And Andrew Mertens dead in front, 42 metres out. Looks like he's got a better piece of ground on which to put his left foot.
There's the plant. There's the kick. It's close. It's just curling behind the posts. Goodness me, this is as tight as wire here at Lancaster Park, 9-8. Francois Pina made a long and impassioned speech to his team, obviously talking to them about the number of penalties and free kicks they've conceded so far. Stransky, deep to Mertens, the two number 10s. Mertens bangs it high. Andre Hubert, now he sometimes taps and goes. He's done it again and clears it up to a piece of the park where there was no one covering.
Hubert saw the vacant space on the left as Jeff Wilson come forward to help chase the kick of Andrew Mertens. He gained a good chunk of territory for the Springboks.
Oh, that's a very close. Out it goes to Little now. Cullen up. Lomu was the decoy. Cullen, straight pass. Joubert, who's got a hamstring. He's torn a hamstring, Andre Joubert. And Cullen went right past him. Referee Mixon blows again for New Zealand. They should have the shot here. There's Joubert talking to the referee. He wants to go off. Cullen zapped him on the inside. And Joubert realizes he's not up to it at the moment and has left the field. Andre Joubert.
Had a niggling hamstring injury, Joubert. The All Blacks working the decoy in the middle and freeing Cullen on the outside, going inside Andre Joubert, who could not move on that injured hamstring. Very quickly sideways, cover defence picking up Cullen. And now we have Springbok replacement.
Justin Swart onto the field.
easy kick, this for Andrew Murdens. 5 metres in from touch, 25 metres out from the goal line.
It's on its way from Mertens. It's a beauty. 12 to 8. 14 minutes gone. Second half. The gap increases now. 4 points. We're watching a tremendous game at Lancaster Park in Christchurch. No tries for New Zealand yet, but 4 penalties to Andrew Mertens. 12 to 8, New Zealand. And Zinzan Brook lets that one go out on the full, and that's an indication that the Springboks are having a continuation of this period of play when they're not right. They've conceded a lot of penalties and made a lot of mistakes.
Well, having to kick the ball off from a muddy area in the middle of the field is difficult. The scrum has been brought off the cricket wicket area, which you can see is muddy, to a place on the ground that has firmer footing.
James Small is the fullback for South Africa with Hubert off. Oh, a lovely run by Cullen coming in to try to get the ball off Walter Little. And that put in there to South Africa is about the first thing that's run their way from the referee in the last 10 minutes or so.
Walter Little, the switch of play had come left, and it's unfortunately couldn't free the ball to Cullen, who was fair motoring down the left-hand side and in space. But defence of the Springboks is very, very good, and the cover defence prevented Walter Little making that transfer.
Justin Swart, who made his debut for South Africa against Fiji this year, is on to the right wing, and James Small has gone back to fullback.
You go down like that, what do you want from it? There's your mark.
It's a free kick for taking the scrum down.
Well, the ball's even in. Free kick.
So what will New Zealand do from this? They can't shoot for goal here. Robin Brook into Herta. It's 30 metres out. His brother, Zinzan Brook. These famous Brook brothers playing epic matches here today. Michael Jones. So pleased to have the chance to play South Africa. Marshall, a good run. Here's some authority coming into the game from New Zealand. Zinzan Brook, Lomu, Mertens, hammered by Mulder.
The ground,
Brook.
It's off the ground. It was never on the ground.
There it is, look at it. Nowhere near the ground.
Referee Mixon makes his point.
Better play from the All Blacks. Ball control was good, heading in close to the rucks and laws to try and take out the defenders who are not committed to the ruck, those forwards that are fringing to hopefully create space wide, but the defence of the Springboks was equal to the task.
Wayne Graham, those scrums are as tough as they were early in the day.
Well, they are, Keith, but just starting to feel as though the All Blacks may be getting on top. They seem to be more consistent and more accurate than the Springboks, and they're starting to do things right where the Springboks are starting to make mistakes under pressure. It just feels from the sideline as though the ball, the game may be starting to slide New Zealand's way.
I guess what they need now is something just to hammer home that advantage and break out past the 7-point gap.
Well, there's still nothing in it. Only 4 points, 12-8 to the All Blacks. It still can go either way, but the New Zealand territorial just starting to take the advantage.
Wayne Graham, 1978-79 All Black on the sideline for us today. Grant Fox, 1985-93 All Black with us, played against the Springboks in 92 in a very close game at Johannesburg. 27-24, I think, Grant. Tough one, wasn't it?
It was a tough one that afternoon. Yeah, we were 27-10 ahead and the Springboks came rushing home at us. Perhaps with a bit more time on the clock may have pipped us, but we managed to hang on.
Roo. Cullen. It hopped up nicely for Christian Cullen. He's banged it back to midfield. Now anything could happen here. Stransky has it. Stransky deep. He thinks Cullen's not there, so he bangs it towards where he should be. And covering is Andrew Mertens. As a little kid, Andrew used to come to the park and watch the All Blacks play, and now he's taking part in an epic game, the 300th Test match New Zealand has ever played. And it's interesting, 150 away from home, 150 like this one.
This match, both sides will be trying to ensure they don't give away penalties in their own territory.
Mertens kicks off. It's a case of shading your eyes into the sun. It's come on to the New Zealand side. Let's see how Mertens sends this one towards James Small, the new fullback. Up goes James. What a good catch. Not a bad effort to come in at fullback and take that one so well.
See, eyes on the ball, never take them off. Airborne to take it. And in this position, despite the fact the ball had gone to ground, Small had no time to play it. And when you're receiving a kick, you therefore get the scrum put in.
That's time Yapi Mulder has kicked well. Very well indeed. South Africa coming out of their own half. Yapi Mulder, remember, he was the fellow that came over as a replacement in 94, made his way into the Springbok Test team on the tour of New Zealand. Back then, when New Zealand won two tests and the third was drawn. New Zealand hasn't scored a try against South Africa for something like over 300 minutes of play. They didn't score one in the World Cup final, or the 18-all draw in the third test in 94, or after 20 minutes of the second test in Wellington. About 303 minutes, we would say, of rugby since New Zealand scored a try against these men in green. But yet, the All Blacks are in front. Little, but halfway. The tackler was Mark Andrews, had a good game. Cronfeld takes the crunch. Marshall making the hard yards, rolling it back. The All Blacks have got to invent something here to extend that lead. They won't want to play the last 15 minutes with just a 1 point. Here's Brett. Little through. Cullen. The chase is on. Cullen and Tyshman. Tyshman saves.
Well done, Gary Tyshman. Good number eight going back and cover defence. Able to force the ball down.
Quick start by Small. A knock on by Jeff Wilson. Good work, James Small.
The quick 22, close to the touchline. Jeff Wilson going down like he was coming forwards for a slips catch. And unable to hold it, put it on the grass. But that's a knock on in this game. Scrum feet to the Springboks.
Stransky. That one's gone a bit long, but it's towards Wilson. And he has to turn and face the sun, and it's a fumble. But he's saved it for the moment. Jeff Wilson, he had to turn, and then the sunlight became a problem for the number 14.
And the kick was wobbling too. Skrensky hadn't hit it quite right. Jeff Wilson running back over his shoulder, and that's very difficult to catch.
First one.
Springboks working to the middle of the field, trying to punch through the midfield just to create a right-hand blindside attacking opportunity.
50-50 ball there. Frank Bunce went in to claim it, just touched it forward.
Tyshman, Rue, Small up from fullback. Cullen takes it over the touchline. Whoa, blocked off by Hendricks, and Ken McCartney has the flag out again. He flagged him in the first half against Robin Brook for the same thing.
It was a shoulder at 50.
And he's going to penalise him. Well, we've got to say that went against New Zealand in the first half. So this is Ken McCartney doing it at least for the same for Christian Cullen. See, no arms in the tackle. And he was nudged across into the advertising hoarding. 4 minutes to go.
He's a pretty tough customer, even for a small man, Christian Cullen.
Oh, great disappointment on the faces of the Springboks too. They knew as soon as it had happened what the decision would be. They knew it would go against them. Absolutely disappointed, because what a fine attacking position that worked themselves into.
Look at the penalties and free kicks, 24 to 12. Hooked down by Jones, untidy. Michael Jones goes in to tidy it up. And There
going forward, it's coming down, Black's ball.
Desperate men now.
It. He took a step forward, it's on the ground, Black ball.
The All Blacks may be fortunate there to get the put in. They had to go back to retrieve it, Michael Jones did that. Referee Megson ruling the All Blacks had a slight advantage by a metre on the push and therefore got the scrum put in.
This is a cliffhanger. And there's an attacking kick from Mertens. Straight to Fenter, who's had a tough game at second probably. Francois Pienaar rips it for South Africa. The Springboks have it, John Allen. Herta plays the halfback. Yapi Mulder, Fitzpatrick leading by example. It's there for Marshall. Pumped by Marshall. The New Zealanders break out. Lomu coming down onto Small. Fireworks will happen if they meet. And Small clears it away to touch.
Justin Marshall taking the wise option. He knew they had to get out of their own territory. Put the long kick in. James Small going back and retrieving the situation for the Springboks. But once again, the All Blacks have withstood a period on defence. Matt up now back in Springbok territory.
The gamble paid off, guys. Mertens took the little chip kick in the middle of the field. Marshall got a hold of it and whacked it down Lancaster Park.
Gamble's the right word, Wayne. I think Merton should have kicked long in the first place.
And here comes the next roll of the rugby dice in this titanic struggle. The morning paper today called it the rematch of the Titans. And it's lived up to that. Marshall decides to hang on. It's there on the New Zealand side. Referee Megson wants it to come. A fumble by Mertens. No, a penalty.
Over the ground, holding the ball in.
Francois Pienaar is a frustrated captain today as the penalty count soars and the time ticks towards 80 minutes. Well, back home in South Africa, I remember how they used to regard Welsh referee Clive Norling after a defeat at Eden Park way back in 81. Maybe Ray Megson will join that little club of referees who South Africans point the finger at. Francois Pienaar has a rueful look on his face.
Yes, he's obviously not a very happy captain at the moment. This kick for Andrew Mertens easier than the one he missed a few minutes ago.
And Robin Brooks stepped forward there to get his shadow off the ball just to make everything right for Mertens. A crucial late kick. It's on its way from the little Canterbury hero, and it's 15-11. South Africa now have to score a try, but hold on. Kids running onto the park. And the referee says it's over. It's all over. 15-11 in 1996. It was 15-12 in the World Cup final in 1995. But this time New Zealand are the victors. They take the 4 points in the championship for this game. South Africa take one for the close finish. What drama we saw unfold on this famous park. The 300th test match involving the All Blacks is a victory for New Zealand by 15-11, but a very tough defeat for South Africa.
Yes, South Africa scoring the only try of the game. It was 8-6 at halftime, but Andrew Mertens with his 5 penalty goals getting the All Blacks home. We'll be back to wrap up after the break.